हेलो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू गाइस आर डूइंग वेल एंड सेफ इन दिस पैंडमिक। आई गेस यू ऑल नो व्हाट इज स्पेशल अबाउट टुडे। या टुडे इज़ द इंटरनेशनल योगा डे। लेट अस गो थ्रू सम फैक्ट्स एंड गेन सम नॉलेज अबाउट योगा। फर्स्ट लेट अस सी सम फैक्ट्स अबाउट योगा। योगा इज 5000 ईयर्स ओल्ड। अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंटरनेशनल योगा फेडरेशन, अबाउट 300 मिलियन पीपल प्रैक्टिस योगा इन द वर्ल्ड। देर आर मोर देन 100 स्टाइल्स ऑफ योगा। Yoga is originally practiced as a form of healing. Yoga boosts the immune system. Ancient yogis believed that we only have a limited number of breaths in each life. Hence, it made sense to stretch our life a bit longer by taking slow and deep breaths. Let us take a look at the origin of yoga. Traditional yoga, also known as classical yoga, arose during the 2nd century and encompasses a wide variety of techniques and teachings. It was preceded by a nearly 2000-year period that is generally known as pre-classical. This style of yoga is referred to as a traditional because it has remained unchanged in form over time. However, the same cannot be said as true, as the other modern yoga styles have been developed to serve a specific need such as flexibility, strength, weight loss, prenatal health, or breathing. This evolution or lack of evolution in the case of traditional yoga style is ideal for virtually everyone, as individuals can choose the yoga style that best suits their personal health goal. Yoga practice is getting more popular worldwide. People all over the world are moving toward practicing yoga for having a healthy life. Things that most of us know about yoga are stretching the body, relaxing, and meditating. But yoga is a wonderful exercise that links the soul to nature and keeps us fit and active. Human beings are made up of three elements, which are mind, body, and soul. Similarly, in order to satisfy the needs of these three, we need knowledge, health, and inner peace respectively. As we know, health is a physical need, whereas knowledge is a psychological need of ours. We all must have found ourselves in a situation where we feel that our responsibilities are endless and deadlines are approaching fast. Most of us are embroiled either in our personal and professional that leads us towards so much pressure that we end up exclaiming, "Oh gosh, I'm so stressed." But do we actually know what stress really is and how it can adversely affect our health? Stress occurs when our mind and body overwork beyond their capability and reach the flight-fight mode. At that time, the mind releases certain hormones and chemicals, particularly cortisol, adrenaline, and norepinephrine, that prepare our body for work but cause certain reactions. Stress is one of these reactions. Stress can be really dangerous for us and can lead to various ailments. The stress can be safely and effectively relieved through yoga. Practice this sequence of yoga poses for stress relief to experience it for real. Here are some of simple yoga poses to relax our mind and attain inner peace. Sugasana, aka easy pose. Vajrasana, diamond pose. Janusirasana, head to knee forward bend. When we talk about physical health, yoga helps us to maintain a proper posture and feel elegant. Sustaining a good posture is a big part of your health. It ensures that your bones are well aligned with the rest of the body, while the tension in your muscles and ligaments are properly distributed. More so, it keeps the body parts in their rightful positions with minimal stress. Here are some of the advantages of a rightful posture. A rightful posture helps muscles to coordinate in a more efficient manner, making the body utilizes less energy, thus eliminating muscle fatigue. This allows one to undertake tasks for longer periods with minimal exhaustion. Holds the spinal joints in place, which is essential in maintaining a good posture. With less stress on the ligaments, coupled with aligned spinal joints, the possibility of injury is greatly minimized. Here are some of the yoga poses to correct your posture. Vyagrasana, Bhujangasana, Marjariasana. To conclude, I would like to say that to have a healthy and harmonious life, it is good to practice yoga. Let me conclude what is said in Bhagavad Gita. Yoga is the journey of the self, through the self, to the self. In the end, I would like to thank you all for giving me this opportunity. Have a wonderful day.